Hello everyone, good evening and welcome back to another episode of our photography review show. I hope you all had a great week and I hope you're ready for more photography fun. Now, if you've never been here before, my name is Jakub. I'm a professional photographer based in West Sussex, England. And this show is my way of helping you with your photography keep moving forward. Now, we have a few things to go through before we start. First of all, what we do, we basically take your images, we look at them, and we try to give you some feedbacks on what you could improve. We usually take the images and divide them into three parts. We look at the technical part. That's where we look at the camera settings, exposure, noise, sharpness, and all this fun stuff. After that, we look at the artistic part. This is where we look at composition, where we look at things like storytelling, framing, and everything to do with that visual impact of your image. And finally, if we have some additional time, I like to take time and give you some tips and tricks on how to do some photo editing. And what we do, we use Luminar Neo for this photo editing part. However, if you use different photo editing application, don't worry too much about it. Most of the tips I'm going to give you are really applicable in any current photo editing software. So three parts: technical, artistic, and photo editing. So that's what we're going to do today. After that, how you can join us? Well, it's really simple. To send your photos over and get them reviewed by me, all you need to do is to join our membership that is called Clever Photographer Plus. And by doing that, you will not only get access to the photography review show, you will also get access to our Clever Photographer Academy Facebook group. And on top of it, you will get a monthly digital photography bundle, which includes generally between 250 to 300 elements to help you with a specific photography style. So for example, now in February, that bundle is focusing on fine art black and white portraits. And in January, it was focusing on fantasy photography. Then throughout the last 2.5 or 3 years, we did all sorts of photography styles: landscape, forest, wildlife, more portrait, travel photography, sunrise, sunset photography, all sorts of photography styles. And we put together a great amount of incredible digital tools that you can use when you edit your images. So to join us, head to our website, cleverphotographer.com/membership. Sign up there and join us already for the next week's show. Now, you may be watching us live on our YouTube channel, Clever Photographer, where we're mostly focusing on Luminar Neo and photo editing, but also we are broadcasting live on our Facebook group, Clever Photographer Academy, and on our Facebook page at Clever Photographer. Looking quickly into the comments, good evening, Zdeněk, to all the way to South Africa. I hope you're doing great. Tony, also our regular, thank you for joining us this evening. Greetings to Essex, to you as well. I hope you guys are fine. If you are watching us online, make sure that you jump into the comments anywhere you write and just say hello. Say, let us know where you're watching from. It would be great to know what kind of audience we have. And if you are watching us in the replay, thank you very much for joining us anyway. I hope you find some of the tips and tricks I'm going to be giving today helpful even for your own photos. So this is all out of the way. Let me just set up right. I'm going to make sure that you can see the screen. And then I'm going to get into the photos. We're going to start nicely from the top with landscape photograph. Photos from Caroline. So I think we have everything set. I think I covered everything. What time is it? 6:07 here in UK. So you know what? Let's jump into it. So starting with the landscape photos, looking at Caroline's capture, here is one right there with almost like a ruin of a castle or old manor with quite nice tree standing on the top of the hill. So we're going to look at that. And then we have this capture of different rock formation with the sea and a lot happening there. So we're going to start with the first image. And as I mentioned at the beginning, we're going to start by looking at the technical part of the image. This is where we look at your camera details and we look at the image closely on that part. So starting with this one, it was captured with Canon 5D Mark IV and with a lens 16 to 35 millimeters. Now from the camera settings, ISO 100, 27 millimeters, f9 and 1/40th of a second. Caroline, nice and low ISO, definitely for this type of photos, for the landscape captures like this, the goal should be 100 on the ISO to make sure that we avoid any additional digital noise. F9 is also great. In general, for a picture like this, where there is no quite dominant foreground element close to the camera, anything between F7.1 and F11 will really give you some of the best performance out of the lens. Usually everything is nice and sharp and it all works. So F9 is also a great choice. 1/40th of a second, just to make sure that we have the details in the sky and the exposure all works. So I think looking at it like this, it's all good. Now, let's just zoom in a little bit. Let's look for the sharpness. Everything looks nice and crisp, including the trees. There is also a little bit of texture in the sky, which is great because sometimes daylight captures like this with the blue sky can be a little bit flat. You know, when you have lots of blue, start to give you color cast on the image and it started to bring really strong shadows, but I think this works quite well. So technically, I think this is nicely done. I don't see much noise neither. So noise, no sharpening grade, all in focus, everything good there. Now, when it comes to the artistic part, let's talk about the kind of first impression when you look at the image. I think the green is quite strong and saturated, so it kind of stands out a lot on the image, and that's to do a little bit with the contrast. You have that kind of lower saturation on the sky, which is quite nice. Then you have that very earthy natural colors on the house as well as on the tree. So those are kind of low tone colors, and then you have the lots of green, quite saturated, which really stands out. So following the idea of the contrast in a composition, that's what really makes the green stand out from the image. So probably what I would do in post-processing, and we can do that in a moment, I would bring the saturation of the green a little bit down just to balance the contrast between the different parts of the image. So that's what I would do there, just to make sure that we don't have just the grass standing out. But on the top of it, I think there's lots of things that are done really nicely. I really like the fact that you are a little bit lower and the structure is on the background of the sky, which I think really makes it stand out from the image rather than for the structure being hidden or blending with the background, which would be even more landscape. So I think the position when you are under it and it kind of gives a contrast against the sky really helps. I think the tree also works really nicely here, giving us really nice sense of depth and also scale, so you have an idea on what you're looking at. Some of these stones and rocks, again, working almost as a foreground and bringing more depth into the image, actually, I think works very well too. So all in all, really nicely done, well composed. Always make sure that you have a little bit of extra space, but in overall, I think it's really nicely done together. So that's it for this image. I promise that we're gonna do a little tweaking in the editing part. So as I say, I think everything is good except the green is just a little bit too strong for me. So in most of the software, in current days, you can find something that is called HSL panel. And here in Luminar Neo, it's hiding inside of the color tool. So when I open it, in HSL panel, you have an option to adjust hue, saturation, and luminance of the individual colors in your image. So for us, we want to adjust saturation and we want to adjust saturation of the greens. So let's jump into the saturation tab and going through the list, you can see that the green is 4th. So what we're going to do, we're going to take the slider and bring it slightly down. Let's have a look somewhere around maybe 20, minus 25, minus 20 is good. Now looking at it, it's adjusting the green a little bit, but not all of it. And the reason being is, as there is quite strong sun coming from that side, it actually giving a little bit of warmer color to the grass, so a little bit of the yellow. And so we need to also adjust the yellow color here. So we're going to do exactly that. We're going to take the yellow slider and bring it down a little bit. And by doing that, you can see how we adjusting the grass just like that. So little bit down on yellow, little bit down on green. Let's have a look, the before and after. And I think that really helps to balance it all together. On the top of it, if we already here, another thing I would do, I would crop out a little bit of the grass away from the image. Following the idea, and this is something I learned when I started with the photography and I was studying composition, my teacher back then was saying that if there is a specific part of the image which doesn't give anything to the story or the story of the image, then it doesn't need to be there. And that's an example here that the grass is nice, the hill is nice, but I just think that there is a little bit too much of it. So what I would do, very simply, I would just use the crop tool quickly, and I would crop a little bit of the bottom away, maybe somewhere around here. We want some of the grass being there, but maybe just not that much. So adjust it like this, then just hit enter. And just like that, I think we have a little bit more impact and focus on the ruin or the old house, which is the main element in that image. And we just balance everything nicely together. So what we did, we lowered the saturation on the grass just to balance the contrast between the different elements of the image. And we cropped a little bit out of it just because it was quite dominant and I wanted to bring back some of the attention on the main subject. So that's it on that image. Let's move on the next one, which is a little bit different. Now, this is almost kind of seascape coastal capture with different rocks and different texture hiding in this kind of darker sea. So let's talk about it. Let's start from the technical part again. Looking at the camera details, same thing, Canon 5D Mark IV, the lens again 16 to 35 millimeters. From the camera settings here, ISO 100, 32 millimeters, f11, and 1/200th of a second. So again, nice and low ISO, especially on the daylight captures. You really want to make sure that you are nice and low like this. F11, as I mentioned, my to-go starting setting is always between f7.1 and f11. F11, if I have something closer to the camera, which is this example right here, just to make sure I have a sharpness all the way through. Now, that is not 100% the rule. Obviously, when you start to work with more complex situation, different time of the day, different light, then you have to adjust it further. But as a starting point, between f7.1 and f11, A, with this wide shot, you will have still sharpness all the way through. B, most of the lenses really perform the best around these numbers, and they just give you the best. Coming back to it, 1/200th of a second, again, give us nice exposure. Now, sharpness, yep, pretty much all the way through, so that's all good there. No noise in the shadows or in a highlight, so that's all good there. Even though some parts are a little bit brighter, I think the exposure is all good too. So all in all, technically, it's quite nicely captured without any visible mistake. So that's all good there. Now, talking about the composition. The time of the day isn't really ideal for multiple reasons. I mean, I don't have a problem with sky not having any texture in it, but the blue is always a little bit overwhelming. And when there is that much of it, it starts to give you that haze I was talking about earlier. You can see it in the shadow. Often when the camera notices quite lots of one of the dominant colors like green or blue, it then starts to push that color into shadows. And here it's quite visible. We have lots of blue in the sky, which is really dominant together with the sea. So then it kind of starts to step in. So that is something to keep an eye on. The time of the day give you kind of stronger shadows, which is a little bit of a shame. You can see that they are quite dominant as well, and they take lots of attention away from the rest of the image. So I would have wished, if my wish would be for this capture, I would have wished that you would have photographed at different time of the day, or that you would have had different conditions. That's about the conditions there. Now, another thing, when looking at it, I'm just trying to figure out what exactly you're trying to show. What is it? What is like the main subject the main subject of the image? What is it that, is it this rock right here? Or is it these rocks? Or is it the contrast between the white rocks and the dark sea? It's a little bit difficult to say what exactly you're trying to show the viewers. although it's a quite nice scene, and I quite like the contrast of the really pale white texture between the dark blue sea and sky. I'm not 100% sure to say what is it that you're trying to show. So that's another thing. The depth is quite nice. Obviously, we have the quite clear foreground and the middle ground and background as a framing with around 1/3 of a sky and 2/3 of a land. I think that can work really nicely too. But I think it's really missing clear idea on what you're trying to show. And just the time of the day with the heavy shadows can be a little bit overwhelming there. So Caroline, not a big problem. It's a lovely capture anyway, technically very well done. Very natural edit, so nothing is really standing out. So that's all good. But for me personally, I would just have hoped for a different time of the day. This one, I really enjoyed. I think it was really nicely done, well captured, great framing, a clear subject, lovely positioning, and quite nice light for this scene, which I think it works really well. So all in all, really, really lovely picture. So that's Caroline. Hello to Ivana from Bechyně. Greetings to you as well. I hope you're doing great. Thank you for joining us live on Facebook, I think. And it's time to continue. Ivana, when you have a moment, send us more pictures. I think I saw some pictures from you in past. So that would be great if you can send us a few over so we can have a look at them again. Moving on, it's time to visit Tony in Essex. Tony, we have 3 captures. Now, let us know in a chat if they are from this year or if it's too early. I seen first flowers this weekend. I think it was a snowdrops, these kind of white flowers. I saw them in a nearby townhouse or like a manor. So that was quite nice. I'm quite excited to start to see flowers back. So I'm assuming this is more captures from last year. However, still, let's have a look at them. So this is very pretty. Oh, I love this. A really nice contrast, really lovely colors, lovely light from the side. So I really enjoy that. So let's start right there. This is Canon 7D with the 18-135mm. From the camera settings, ISO 160, 102mm, f6.3 and 1/100 of a second. So from the camera settings, nice and low ISO. All good there. 102mm in a combination with that f6.3, giving you quite nice soft background. So that works really nicely too. 1/100 of a second, giving you quite balanced exposure there. You get really nice details all across. Nothing seems overexposed or underexposed. So all good and looking well. Sharpness, mostly on a foreground with a kind of quite nice and smooth depth of the field and going into the background. So I think that works really nicely too. I really enjoy the light. You get nice, pleasant highlights with otherwise quite diffuse light. The shadows, they're not really distracting there either. So it works really well. I really, really enjoy this image with that little bit of a warm glow coming from the side altogether is really nicely done. Noise-wise, there is a little bit when you look at it, and I don't know, maybe if you had to push a little bit the exposure to bring it up or why, there is a little bit of visible noise in these areas, but no overwhelming, so I think it actually works quite nicely. Bringing us into the artistic part, this is where I think lots of things work really well. The depth of field with that clear focus on the main subject works really well with really nicely balanced softer background. I think that works really nicely too, because often you see really blurry soft background, which works in some scenes, but I think in this, the background being soft but still a little bit visible can help with the overall story. Contrast, I already mentioned, between the color and the background works really well. Then 5 subjects, which works really well. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These numbers work generally very well as a subject. So again, nicely done. Framing, although it's almost kind of story crop, I think it works nicely too. It just kind of follows the shape of the flower. And with that kind of warm glow coming from a side, it's very storytelling. So Tony, lots of good stuff here. I think the image works very, very well. So well done on that and well done on this capture. Moving to the other 2 pictures, let's say Let's see which one we're going to talk about. This is a good example of the light being just a little bit too strong all across, giving you these kind of shadows around, and the saturation immediately kind of hype out when this sun is coming from the side. So this is example where I think a little bit of diffusion would have helped for the overall scene. On the opposite, I think here it works quite nicely. Probably the light was quite strong too, but because it's kind of hitting it from a side, these little shadows actually helps in overall, as it's coming mostly from the side, I think it actually creates quite nice play with the highlights and shadows, and I think it works quite nicely. So in fact, let's talk about this image, which was captured with Canon 7D and with the lens 18 to 135 millimeters. Now, from the camera settings, we are on very similar numbers as the first image, ISO 160, 102 millimeters, f6.3, and 1/100 of a second. So, following the similar idea, nice and low ISO to avoid additional digital noise, 102 millimeters, giving us kind of softer background, but still very much a recognizable background, which works really well. F6.3 with that length of the lens works nicely too. And 1/100 of a second is a good exposure. Again, nice balance between the highlights and shadows. So all in all, well captured altogether. Looking at it, the sharpness mostly on the main subject with a nice soft blend into the background. So that works well. Again, a little bit of noise in these areas. On the darker parts, on the shadows, you can see it a little bit more than the highlights. But in overall, there is a little bit there. Also, the center of the flower isn't super sharp, super crispy sharp, but it's not a big deal. Still, I would probably like a little bit more sharpness in this area here. And the exposure, it's quite nice. Again, as I mentioned, I think it's nicely balanced. So all good there. Composition-wise, storytelling, I always really enjoy a square crop on these kind of individual subjects. I think that can work really well, especially on subject like this, on the flower. It really helps to focus on the main subject. You can then add nice vignette around, close the image, make almost like a painterly effect with that. And I think it works really well. The edit and overall is really nicely done. Very kind of natural colors. Nothing, not too much of anything, so that's all good there. And I really like it. I really enjoy this image. Between the two, I think the sharpness is something that I find a little bit distracting, because the longer you look at it, more you can see it. But I think a lot is well there. I really like the background and foreground. I think it works nicely together as a foreground, middle ground, and background there. Also the contrast of the colors. The fact that it mostly only has the purple and green works really nicely together as well. So all good there, Tony. Thank you very much for sharing your images with us again. Thank you for sending them over, and well done on your great captures. That brings us to second part of our photographers. We have Ed with two images here, this very dramatic black and white landscape. And this probably a travel capture with a gentleman, making a coal or burning wood, but we're going to talk about that in a moment. Let's start with this one right here, which is captured by Panasonic camera. So I'm assuming maybe a mobile phone, with the camera settings on this one, ISO 125, 9.1 millimeter on the lens, and f3.2 and 1/2000 of a second. So regardless on what was it captured with, I mean, the ISO is nice and low, f-stop is super low. So this is where I'm kind of inclining into the mobile phone. And 1/2000 of a second, making me kind of, I'm assuming that it was actually quite bright day, and that maybe you have done some adjustments to the sky, or I think it was quite sunny, probably day. Also looking at the shadows, it's kind of more visible coming from there. So I think from camera settings, it looks all good. Now let's have a look at the sharpness. The sharpness is quite nice too, all the way towards the end of the rocks. There is a little bit of noise kind of in these areas, but nothing crazy neither. So that's all good. The exposure, As I say, the shadows are a little bit stronger, but in overall, it's quite nice, giving you quite nice contrast. It's nicely handled, so all of that is good. Now, Ed, let's move into the composition and the overall idea of the image. You have this kind of quite nice opening when you have a nice contrast of the texture and different elements, these rocks together with the kind of white foreground and middle ground. I think all of that works well. Where I start to struggle is towards the end of the image and with the sky. I think the sky, because of the amount of contrast and because of the amount of kind of clarity in it, or maybe texture, I think the sky takes lots of attention away from the foreground. So where you kind of have a lots of this white, nicely contrasted with the foreground, I think the sky is just a little bit too overwhelming. So I would adjust that. Maybe next time use less defined editing to the sky. Leave the sky alone there, you know, just add maybe a little bit of texture to it. But for me, mostly I would focus on the foreground, which I think in this case would really help. So that would be the main point on this image. Otherwise, I think the framing is really good. The foreground, I think, works really well here. The depth is nice. It's a lovely idea with the black and white conversion. So all of that works nicely. My main issue is with the sky. So what we could do very quickly, just to give you an idea, I would probably brighten up the sky a little bit. So let's say somewhere around here. Definitely make it a little bit softer. So let's do that. Let's quickly select the sky with a brush. If we can just adjust the size and brush over it very quickly. So we'll do that. Now, it's not the perfect selection. It's just to give us an idea. So brighten that up a little bit, just like that. And immediately, once you brighten it up, when you have a look at it before and after, you can see how the rocks and the mountains immediately stand out from the image, where until now, you almost stop looking at them, you're looking at the sky. Where when you brighten up the sky, you can see that we get much more contrast between the sky and the rocks, and I think that really helps. So that's what I would do there. And then I would copy this mask and more soft and dreamy. We can do that with simple minus clarity, or here in Luminar Neo with minus structure. And again, apply it only to that part of the image. So if we do that, that should be, let's have a look at it before and after. Again, maybe a little bit more minus. And I think that works all together. Now, on the opposite side, you could actually add a little bit more contrast to it. So let's say something like this. And I think that would help. So let's have a look at it before and after. And I think that balances the image much better together. So that was the first photo. Now the second photo, a little bit of kind of documentary travel capture with obviously lots of texture, storytelling. You know, starting from the part of where you're trying to see what you're trying to show. Again, we have the main subject, obviously the gentleman standing there around all these pieces of wood. Now, if I would say that he's the main subject, I would probably like him to be a little bit more in focus. Yeah, a little bit more sharper, a little bit more standing out of the image, where when I zoom in a little bit, he has a kind of glow around him. You can see it right here. And he's definitely not sharp. Probably the sharpness when I look at it is mostly around this area. So that's where I kind of struggle with this image mostly. There's also quite lots of noise in the sky and around these areas. But again, coming back to the overall idea of main subject storytelling, he's the main subject. I would like him to get all the attention, including, you know, being sharp and being all in focus. But coming to the camera settings, again, Panasonic. So if I say that it was captured with mobile phone, I wonder if I'm right. Camera settings, ISO 125, 145 millimeters, f4, 1/640th of a second. So from the camera settings, that all looks good. Although if it was a mobile phone, maybe the scene was a little bit too high dynamic. However, again, as I say, I think the focus is the main thing. There is definitely a noise which may be coming from the zoom. So that's maybe a little bit distracting there. But on the opposite, yeah, I think in overall, it's lovely photo. Definitely, you can see clearly the main subject. The capture of it works really well. It's an interesting scene. He definitely stand out from it. And probably if you know a little bit more of the overall image and you know what you're trying to show, it would probably stand out even further. So Ed, interesting capture. Definitely nice that you try different things from landscape, turn into the black and white, into a little bit of travel photography. I think it all works really well. So well done on that. Just a few things that I mentioned maybe to look at and try to improve for the future. And that will bring us nicely to the fourth and final photographer for today, and that's Zdeněk. By the way, still coming back to the comments, greetings to Mark in Plymouth in UK. Mark, I hope you're doing great. Thank you very much for joining us live. I hope that you are going to enjoy the show. And if you want to join us for the next episode. Zdeněk and usually send us some portrait photos. So we have a young lady here with a beautiful capture from little closer up, and the capture right here with a little bit wider again with another lady. I wonder if it's the same woman, but I don't think so necessarily. But still, let's start with this capture right here, and let's start by looking at the camera details. So this is Canon 600D with 55 to 250 millimeters. Camera settings, ISO 100, 65 millimeters on the lens, f5, 1/125th of the second. From the camera settings, I think you spot on there, quite enjoy it. I think the ISO, obviously, nice and low, 65 millimeters, so it's gonna punch in, which I think works nicely here, giving a really nice shape of the face. F5, giving us this quite nice soft background, although it also gives us quite nice sharpness around the eyes and across the face, so I think that works nicely too. 1/125th second, everything looks nice and sharp and in focus, so everything good there. I tell you what, Zdeněk, I really like the image. I think it's really, really nice. I think there's a character in the face. There is definitely some of the features standing out. It gives us a lovely contrast between the background and the foreground. In overall, it really works. I like the colors. I like the combination of everything. It's a lovely, lovely shot and lovely capture. So from the technical part, I think it's all good. I think it's all nicely done. As I say, the sharpness, the camera settings, I think that's all good there. For the storytelling, for the composition, I think it's, again, nicely done. Obviously, nice close-up shot with a little bit of kind of leaning point of the tree, a little bit of texture in it, which helps to kind of divide the image. I think the depth really works nicely too, almost giving us the bokeh effect. Again, I think the capture of the face, all the details, that it's not like overly edited, I think works nicely too. So in overall, I think it's very, very lovely. Yes, I mean, if you would want to, you could probably try to play around with further sliders, maybe, you know, adjusting a little bit the background, make it a little bit darker. You could do a little bit of dodge and burn around the face. But I don't necessarily think that this quite natural capture needs it, because I think it actually works quite nicely. So all in all, I really enjoy this image. Very well done. Next brings us to the second image. Now, this one, again, Canon 600D with 55 to 250 millimeters. From the camera setting, ISO 100, 60 millimeters on the lens, f5.6, and 1/160th of a second. Zdeněk, on this one, I think the camera settings, again, are spot on. I think the light is a little bit stronger here. On the first one, it seems a little bit more diffused, so I think that worked quite well. On this one, there's kind of, you can see that the light is coming quite strong from kind of up point. You can see some of the darker shadows under her body and over the hat, which I think is just a little bit of a shame. And I think maybe because I've seen this image before, and the light looks really nicely here, coming from this side, creating really nice effect on her face, I think this one is just a little bit harsh. And on top of it, where I'm coming from this image, where you can see really nice details on the face and her features standing out, on this one, for some reason, when I look at it, her face really looks overprocessed for some reason. The features are almost gone. It really kind of glows. It looks very unnatural, at least on my screen. Maybe it looks differently on yours, but yeah, that stands out a lot. Also, for some reason, I don't know if you can see it, I see this kind of red like artifacts from editing. You can see it on her hair here. You can also see it in her eye. And that's it pretty much. I can only see there. But yeah, that's just a shame. Also, it takes a little bit away from the overall image. So those are my main things that kind of stands out from it. And they take a little bit away from the overall photo. For the composition, I think it's well thought. I think it's something else. I think using the tree can work really nicely. It creates the kind of frame around her. The position or how she poses, I think, works nicely too. I would probably drop the hat, but that's just very much artistic decision. But definitely, I think you can see the overprocessing on the face. And then you get these red highlights, which almost looks like clipping for some reason. Or I'm not sure why. But I think they also need to be look at a little bit. So a little bit more diffuse light, less touching on the skin to keep the characteristic and the feature, especially when it's really visible. And then keep an eye on these red highlights to make sure that it all works. So first one, I love lots of character, very natural edit, lots of good things there. Second one, I think needs a little bit of tweaking with what I told you on that. So, Zdeněk, thank you very much, as always. It was great to see your portrait photos as well. Well done, well edited, well sent over. And thanks to all of you, Ed, Tony, Caroline. Thank you guys for sending your images over. It was great to see them. And I hope that I can see more of your photos next week. Next week is actually, I believe it's next week, is one of our last show for February. I'm away to France for work for a few weeks. So if you want to join us, make sure that you come back next week for the episode. Otherwise, we'll see each other at the beginning of March. Also, if you are from UK or if you're coming to UK for the photography show in Birmingham, I believe it's mid-March, I will be there together with the Skyline team on their little stand, and I will be there throughout the whole time of the show. And if you're there, I would love to meet you, love to see you and talk to you about Luminar Neo or about photography or anything. It would be great to put some of your faces together live in person. So if you're going to be at the Birmingham Photography Show next month, I would love to see you there. Folks, have a lovely evening. Thank you very much for joining me. If you're watching live, if you are watching in replay, thank you and have a lovely evening. See you next week.